start about teaching. So hello and welcome back, dear all students, to another video tutorial from Genome Biotech. And the topic of today's talk is about amino acid catabolism. So basically, we have to now talk about that what is amino acid catabolism? How does amino acid catabolism takes place? What happens in the case of catabolic reactions? Okay, or basically, what is catabolism? Amino acid catabolism refers to all the different types of reactions that are involved in the breakdown of amino acid. Okay, so each and every reaction which is being involved in the breakdown of amino acid is referred to as catabolism. So now, how does amino acid catabolism is going to take place? Okay, that we will have to see. This is amino acid catabolism. Okay, now the process of catabolism takes place in this particular, you can understand this out, the process of catabolism could be effectively understood in this particular reaction pathway, okay, which is being described here. Just a second. This is the reaction pathway that we have to have a look. See what is going to happen in this reaction pathway. The proteins or whether any other amino acid which is present, the proteins which are present, those proteins are being firstly broken down into free amino acids. Now can you tell me the enzyme that is involved in the breakdown of the proteins into free amino acid? The enzyme is referred to as the proteases. Proteases are involved in this particular breakdown. Okay, so proteases are involved. So proteases are going to break the protein molecules. Okay, once the protein molecule is being broken into free amino acid, now the amino acid, as you know, the amino acid are the structures that contains a carboxyl group present within themselves. There is a COOH group along with the carboxyl group. Then you have the amino group. Then you have another amino group. There is a group that is present. That group is referred to as the amino group NH2. There is another group that is present. That is referred to as the hydrogen atom. And the fourth group that is referred to as the side group. So now what has to be done? Which is the waste product which is present in our body? The waste product that is present in our body is the nitrogen. Nitrogen always act as a waste product. Okay, so nitrogen is the one that is going to act as the waste product in your body. Okay, so that has to be removed. Now, how it is going to be removed, that we have to see. Now, nitrogen has to be removed. जी सर मैं क्लास में हूँ मैं थोड़ी देर में बात करता हूँ. Now nitrogen has to be removed, and this nitrogen has to be removed by a reaction that is referred to as the deamination reaction. Now deamination reaction is a reaction in which the nitrogen is going to be removed. Now how this nitrogen is going to be removed? The nitrogen is going to be removed through this reaction that is referred to as the deamination reaction. Just a second, it is referred to as the deamination reaction. Okay, now in this deamination, nitrogen is being removed in the form of ammonia. And an alpha keto acid is being produced. Now see how the degradation, how the deamination is going to take place. See, this is going to happen in the case of deamination. Now supposingly you remove this ammonia, then what you get is there is would be a carbon molecule that would be present, and along with this carbon there is carboxyl group that is present, COOH. Okay, carboxyl group that is present. Along with the carboxyl group there would be a keto group that would be present, double bond O, a hydrogen atom that would be present, and lastly a side chain in the form of R. Now this amino acid has gotten interconverted into a keto acid. Now amino acid has been transformed into a alpha keto acid. This alpha keto acid will get modified itself and will enter into the citric acid cycle, just like alpha keto glutarate. You know that alpha keto glutarate can enter into the citric acid cycle. Okay, and during the citric acid cycle, the alpha ketoglutarate undergo decarboxylation, leading to the formation of water and ATP. Now we have to see that how the deamination reactions take place. which is the enzyme that is required in the deamination reaction. So which are the different enzymes that are being involved in the process of deamination, that we would have to have a look. Now look here, just a second, let me clear these drawings. Amino acid deamination. Now amino acid deamination, there are two different, the removal of the amino group from an amino acid can be catalyzed by two different reactions. Which are the two different reactions that can be used in the removal of this amino group from the amino acid, that we have to see. So which is the reaction that is involved in the removal of this amino group from the amino acid? Those reactions are transamination reaction. And there is another reaction that is present, that is called as oxidative deamination. Okay, so one is transamination, another one is oxidative deamination. Now, what do you mean by transamination, that we have to see? And what do you mean by oxidative deamination? Now, to remove this amino group, the amino group, which is the most troublesome group, which is present in the amino acid, the amino group has to be removed. Now, for the removal of this amino group, what has to be done? The amino group can be removed by two different reaction mechanisms, as I have told you, the transamination and oxidative deamination. Firstly, you can transfer the amino group from one amino acid to a keto acid. And after transferring it into the keto acid, you form another amino acid. Now, this could be understood like this. Now, if you have an old bike, you have an old washing machine, you have an old TV, then during the exchange offers at Diwali and at other different festivals, what you do? You took the old materials to the market and get them replaced with a new one. Okay, so this is how we are going to work. And here also, transamination, which involves an enzyme that is referred to as aminotransferases or transaminases, creates a reaction in which an amino acid, an old amino acid which is present in excess, can donate its proton, it can donate its ammonium group. And when it can donate its ammonium group, then this amino acid, then the other one amino acid will get converted into the alpha keto acid, and the other alpha keto acid will get converted into the amino acid. Transamination is a reaction in which the amino acids gets transformed into an alpha keto acid, and another alpha keto acid gets transformed into an amino acid. To look at more clearly upon transamination reaction, we must look at Lippincott. Okay, this is urea cycle that we are going to talk about. But before the urea cycle, you must understand what happens in the case of transamination. See, this is the disposal of amino acid. This is the transamination reaction. Okay. See, this is the topic. Removal of nitrogen atoms from the amino acid. Now, how the removal of nitrogen atom is going to take place from the amino acid? So the removal of nitrogen from the amino acid follows two different reactions. One is referred to as the transamination reaction. First reaction that is being involved is referred to as the transamination reaction. Another reaction that is being involved is referred to as deamination reaction. So firstly, let me talk about transamination one. Now, for example, there are two different enzymes which are involved in transamination reaction. Alanine aminotransferases and aspartate aminotransferases. Okay. These are the two different enzymes, the two enzymes involved in transamination, the A enzyme and the B enzyme. This alanine aminotransferases causes the transamination reaction from alanine to take place. The pyruvate can get converted into alanine. In the process, when pyruvate will get converted into alanine, the alpha-ketoglutarate will get converted into glutamate. See this? This is an amino acid. That means amino group will be added. See what is... Just a second. What is going to be done? This is an amino acid. Okay. So this amino acid has an amino group. Okay. This amino acid has an amino group that is present in the form of NH2. Okay. There is the amino group that is present. This amino acid is going to donate its amino group to the alpha keto glutarate, which is a keto acid, and will form a new amino acid that would be referred to as the glutamate. Will form another amino acid, and this amino acid will be referred to as the glutamate. And alpha-ketoglutarate getting converted into glutamate, pyruvate, alanine getting converted into pyruvate. See, alanine one was an amino acid, and it has now gotten converted into pyruvate. This cycle, which involves the interconversion of alanine to pyruvate, is referred to as pyruvate-alanine cycle. This cycle that involves pyruvate interconversion to alanine is called as pyruvate alanine cycle. Okay, this is referred to as the pyruvate alanine cycle. Okay, probably you can look at it. Sorry, now I cannot change that up. So the cycle that involves the pyruvate interconversion to alanine is called as pyruvate alanine cycle. Okay, so this cycle is called as the pyruvate alanine cycle. Now let me look forward. Just let me clear these all. Now there is another amino acid that is involved called as aspartate aminotransferase. Here the aspartate, everyone is knowing the name alanine aminotransferase. So alanine is going to donate the amino group. Alanine is going to transfer the amino group. That is why the enzyme name is alanine aminotransferase. Another enzyme name is aspartate aminotransferase. That means who is going to donate the amino group? It is always the aspartate that is going to donate the amino group. So aspartate will act as an amino group donor. So here aspartate is going to donate the amino group and it will convert the alpha ketoglutarate into glutamate. Okay, so we have studied two different types of transamination reaction. One is catalyzed by alanine aminotransferases, another one by aspartate aminotransferases. So these are the two basic reactions that we have seen. Okay, these are the enzymes that are referred to as transaminases. Now, transaminases is also referred to as aminotransferases. They have the same name, aminotransferases. Either you call them transaminases or you call them aminotransferases. Now, to just have a look at the reaction mechanism, if you are going to read it, the first step in the catabolism of most amino acids is the transfer of amino group to alpha keto acid. Okay, this is referred to as transamination reaction. The product are an alpha keto acid and glutamate. Alpha keto glutarate plays a pivoted role in amino acid metabolism, accepting the amino group from most amino acids, thus becoming glutamate. Glutamate produced by transamination can be oxidatively deaminated or used as an amino acid donor in the synthesis of other non-essential amino acids. Now, glutamate, which would be produced at the end of the biochemical reaction, can be transformed to form other different chemical compounds, okay, or can be transformed into non-essential amino acids. Okay, now substrate specificity of aminotransferases. Each and every aminotransferase is highly specific. When you talk about alanine aminotransferase, that means this aminotransferase is going to act upon alanine and not upon any other molecule. When you talk about aspartate aminotransferase, then aspartate aminotransferase will transfer the group from the aspartate and not to any other molecule. So they are highly specific chemical compounds in nature. Okay. Now moving forward, just a second. Now moving forward, what you get is the complete reaction mechanism, the complete picture of this transferases, the transaminases, aspartate aminotransaminase. Now see this. Aspartate will act as an amino group donor. So see, this is the amino group that is present. And aspartate is going to donate this amino group to the enzyme that is referred to as transaminase. Transaminase enzyme, as I have already told you, the transaminase enzyme is a complex enzyme in which the lysine residue, which is a basic amino acid residue. Can anybody tell me the symbol of lysine? What is the symbol of lysine? K. It is being remembered by K. Okay, lysine is K. If you look at the structure of lysine, the maximum number of rotatable bonds are present in lysine. It contains an epsilon amino group. In its structure, you will find an epsilon amino group. Dear all, if you have to make your biochemistry strong, please do remember all the different structure of all the different types of amino acids. Okay, those who knows me in the classroom program, they know me very well that I do remember all the structures. So there is the epsilon amino group, and here is a bond which is being produced, okay? And this is the CH2 group of the pyridoxamine phosphate that is being bound to it, okay? So pyridoxamine phosphate is bound to the active site of the amino transferase residue. Amino group is not directly transferred from one substrate to another, but amino group is firstly transferred to pyridoxamine phosphate. And it is this pyridoxamine phosphate that will transfer this amino group to another molecule. It would be this amino group that will be transferred to another molecule, ultimately leading to the biosynthesis of the new amino acid that would be referred to as alpha, that would be referred to as your glutamate. See this glutamate donating up amino group, and this amino group will be moving towards the oxaloacetate, and oxaloacetate getting converted into aspartate. This is how the reaction is going to take place. See the arrows, you can look at the arrows. The amino group is being donated by glutamate. It donates the amino group to this compound that is pyridoxamine phosphate. Later on, it is this amino group that is being transferred to oxaloacetate. This amino group is being transferred to oxaloacetate, this carbon atom. And as it is being transferred to oxaloacetate, it gets converted into aspartate. So this would be referred to as glutamate oxaloacetate amino transferases. Okay, so that it is going to take the molecule from the glutamate. So this would be referred to as glutamate amino transferases. Glutamate amino transferase. Okay, so this would be the chemical compound. This would be the name of the compound that would be produced. This is the name of the compound, glutamate amino transferase. The name of this particular reaction. See, now you would have come to a common conclusion. See, the name of the amino transferase, the name of the amino transferases is on the basis of their donor substrate molecule. You can look at the above reactions also. What was the name of the transferase? Alanine amino transferase, because alanine was the donor. Aspartate amino transferase, because aspartate was the donor. Here, which compound is the donor? Glutamate. So this is glutamate amino transferases, okay? During the aspartate amino transferase reaction, this is the reaction that is going to take place. Now these are referred to as transaminases, okay? Now please look here at the pathfinder. Let us look at the at pathfinder. What is given in pathfinder? Let me have a look for you all. Okay. So see, similar information is given in Pathfinder, okay? Now what type of information they are talking about is that, now see, this is the reaction that is referred to as transamination. In this reaction, what is going to happen? Transamination reaction, dominant reaction involved in removing amino acid nitrogen are referred to as the transamination reaction. So these are the reactions that are involved in the removal of the nitrogen atom. And such type of reaction is referred to as transamination reaction. Okay, so in this reaction, what is going to happen? All amino acids except lysine and threonine and proline participate in transamination during catabolism. This is very important. There are three amino acids that cannot undergo transamination, and those three amino acids are lysine, threonine, and proline. Again, questions have been asked that which are the three amino acids that do not undergo transamination reaction. Now see, because of their structure, because of their very large complex structure, the three amino acids, that is lysine, threonine, and proline, can never undergo transamination reaction. These three amino acids cannot undergo transamination reaction. Okay. Now, transamination reactions are easily reversible reactions. The reactions are being catalyzed with the help of an enzyme, and that enzyme is referred to as the amino transferases, also referred to as transaminases. These reactions are being catalyzed by amino transferases or transaminases. Okay. Each amino transferase is specified for one or two amino acids. Amino transferases are named after the specific amino group donor, because the acceptor of the amino group is almost an alpha keto glutarate. Okay, so amino transferases are named after the specific amino acid donor. So they are being named after the name of the donor that is referred to as amino transferases. Okay, because now you have come to know that on the basis of the donor of the amino acid, they are being named. You can look here how they are being named. They are being named as glutamate amino transferase or glutamate transaminase, also referred to as alanine amino transferase, because this alanine is the donor. This aspartate is the donor. That glutamate was the donor. Now moving forward, amino transferases require participation of an aldehyde containing coenzyme pyridoxal 5-phosphate. I have already told you. Now what is very important is the formation of Schiff's base, that how does Schiff's base formation take place, and what actually is Schiff's base. Okay, now you look here, amino transferases require the participation of an aldehyde containing cofactor called as pyridoxal 5-phosphate. And this pyridoxal 5-phosphate is of key importance. Okay, this pyridoxal 5-phosphate is also referred to as vitamin B6. So vitamin B6 act as a cofactor for the transaminases and for the transamination reaction. Okay, so that is referred to as vitamin B6. Okay, pyridoxal 5-phosphate is covalently attached to the enzyme via a Schiff's base linkage formed by the condensation of aldehyde group with the epsilon amino group of lysine residue. This is very important. Look here. This is what I was telling you in the diagram. Sorry, I have dropped this diagram. If I can bring it back. No, I cannot bring it back. I will have to remake. You can assume that there, this is the complex structure of the enzyme. Now here you will get the lysine amino acid residue. There is an amino acid residue that is referred to as lysine. Okay. That is referred to as K. And this bond is the one that is referred to as the Schiff's base. Okay, this is referred to as the Schiff's base. Because what is going to happen? This compound will get converted into an aldehyde. See this? This is the aldehyde group. Okay, now it is this aldehyde group that is being interacting with the epsilon amino group of lysine. And the bond which is being produced is referred to as the Schiff's base. There would be a bond that would be produced, and that bond will be referred to as Schiff's base. Okay, so this bond will be referred to as the Schiff's base bond. Okay, so this is how the Schiff's base is being produced. A very important question. More than 4 times this question has been asked in CSIR NET JRF entrance examination. And you will have to answer it properly, that these are referred to as Schiff's base. Okay. Now please, let us move forward and let us look forward that what is going to happen. What happens with the formation of this Schiff's base? Moving back to Pathfinder. This point is of utmost importance. Please do remember it. Okay. Now moving back to Pathfinder, pyridoxal 5-phosphate is covalently attached to the enzyme via a Schiff's base linkage. Now while I am always teaching, try to bring Pathfinder along with you, in front of you, while I am teaching, so that you can underline the most important points. Try to have a look at Lippincott also. If you have any other book, you have Strad, you have Leninger, you have any other book, you can have a reading of those particular books. Okay, all those books are even available in PDF versions. So you can ask from anybody in the groups. Everybody is going to help you out. Okay, now see, the condensation of when the condensation of the aldehyde is going to take place with the epsilon amino group of the lysine residue, then the base which is being produced is referred to as the Schiff's base. Okay, then the base that is being produced is called as the Schiff's base, the most important one. This is the most important one. Okay, you must remember this out. Okay, now amino transferase act. Now this is the last definition. Amino transferase act by transferring amino group of one amino acid to the pyridoxal part of the coenzyme to generate pyridoxamine phosphate. Then the pyridoxamine will transfer the amino group to another alpha keto acid, forming another new amino acid, and it will regenerate the original aldehyde form of the coenzyme. Then it will regenerate the original aldehyde form of the coenzyme. Okay, so what is going to happen? See, they have clearly written. Pranav sir has already described this complete process, and I have described the same with the help of Lippincott. I have told you in the chelation of Lippincott, this is pyridoxamine phosphate that will be produced on the transfer of this amino group. Okay, and then this amino group will be transferred to another molecule, another substrate, where it will get converted into a product. Okay, now amino acid reacting with an alpha keto acid, forming another alpha keto acid and an amino acid. This is how the process is going to take place. Now, some of the students might think, sir, see this, there is only a one amino acid that can undergo oxidative deamination. Okay, that is referred to as glutamate and glutamine and alpha ketoglutarate. Actually, see, glutamine can take three amino groups. Glutamine is highly special. It can take three amino acid molecules present within itself. How it can take three amino acid molecules? Please just for a second, you can have a look here. See this. Glutamine can take three amino acid. Now, when there is the glutamine that is present, sorry for the disturbance, I am answering the questions of the students. See, this is all given in Pathfinder, and if you are not able to find it out, then you are not in the proper chapter. In the new Pathfinder, this entire amino acid unit has been described into two different categories. One was referred to as the basic amino acid that we were talking about. Another one is the chapter number second that is given referred to as amino acid that is referred to as bioenergetics and metabolism. In the case of metabolism, you will get these types of reaction. And if you are not even able to locate it up, then just try to find out urea cycle. See, urea cycle is just given after this. Okay, so just you try to find out urea cycle from the appendix. And once you find it out, the urea cycle, you just move two pages before urea cycle, you will be able to get it. Yes, it is amino acid catabolism. There you can find it out, okay? Sorry, I have answered it to someone else and I had to answer it to someone else. Okay. Sorry. Okay, now see this, when you are going to talk about glutamine, this glutamine will have three amino group. Okay, one is referred to as NH2 group, which will be present in the side chain. One would be the NH2 group that would be present in the main chain. Okay, just a second, there are some queries of students. No, it's also there in the old Pathfinder, dear all students. Try to find it out from the appendix, from the last page of the book. In the last page of the book, see, there would be a catalog given. From that last page, please try to find the urea cycle. If you can find the urea cycle, you will be able to determine it. Okay, whether it is Trishla, whether it is Ankita, whether it is Shalu. Please, students, try to help each other because only this para not given. No, it cannot happen. Every paragraph would be given. So, might be if this paragraph is not given, you can note it down. Okay, sometimes sir used to revise the book and he used to miss some part of it. No problem. Now, we are going to move forward. Okay. Now, see, glutamine that is present. One is glutamate, another one is referred to as glutamine. In the glutamate, there is only one amino group that is present. In the glutamine, there would be two amino groups that would be present. Okay. In the alpha ketoglutarate, there would be again one amino group that would be present. Now, the keto group has been modified. OK. Okay, so there is the amino acid. Amino acid has been no. There would be sorry. Just because I was answering a query, I was not able to concentrate here. Sorry, there is a keto group that is present. There is no amino group. Amino group was present in the amino acid. Okay, so there was an amino group that was present, and now the amino group will be transferred to the keto acid. When amino group will be transferred to the keto acid, then this keto acid will get converted into glutamate by the transfer of this amino group. You can find this is the acid that has been interconverted into the glutamate, and the amino acid getting interconverted into alpha keto acid. This complete reaction is referred to as transamination reaction. See why glutamine was being selected as the most important amino acid? Because glutamine is the only amino acid that can undergo oxidation at an appreciable rate. Okay, it can undergo oxidative deamination at an appreciable rate. Okay, so it is this amino acid that will undergo deamination reaction. Only glutamate is the amino acid that has the ability to undergo oxidative deamination at a very fast pace. That is why it has been extensively used, or it has been extensively employed in the deamination reaction to take place. Now let me move forward. Okay, there is another query on page number 237 in 7th edition. Yes, on page number 237 in 7th edition. Anybody using 4th or 5th edition, they can also share the page number so that other students can also be benefited. Okay. Now there is the other cycle. The other cycle is referred to as the glucose-alanine cycle. So thank you, Neetu, for that. Now see this, I have already told you. Now see, there is a problem that is going to arise in your RBCs. What type of a problem is going to arise in the RBCs? Now please think of a scenario that your RBCs are forming excess amount of pyruvate. Pyruvate is also referred to as pyruvic acid. Now, in the case of RBC, in the case of muscles, what is going to happen when you are going to do exercises? Then glucose getting converted into pyruvate. When glucose will get converted into pyruvate, which is also referred to as pyruvic acid, Pyruvic acid is acidic in nature, okay? Because this is acid, so this will lower down the pH. The pH is less than 7. When the pH will be less than 7, then it will cause the death of the cells to take place. Then how to prevent the death of the cells? Because pyruvic acid has such a lower pH. So what happens? Pyruvate is being transaminated to form alanine. You can look at the structure of pyruvate. So please tell me the formula of pyruvate. Namrata RG, can you tell me the structure of pyruvate? Oh, sorry, my screen is hanged. Not working. Are you able to visualize and hear me up? Please write it down. See, pyruvate is... No, I'm not able to... My cursor is moving, but I cannot change any screen or anything else. I cannot even open the options. Just a second. Now see, this pyruvate is CH3COCOOH that is present. Pyruvate CH3COCOOH will be getting converted into alanine. Now, alanine is an amino acid that is present. When pyruvate is getting converted into a modified amino acid, then this pyruvate, which was acidic, has been neutralized to form an amino acid. An amino acid at the blood pH behaves as zotrine. It moves into the blood. In the liver, again, the alanine will be converted into pyruvate. And through gluconeogenesis cycle, this pyruvate can get converted into glucose. Such type of cyclic reaction, which takes place in the human body, is commonly referred to as the pyruvate-alanine cycle. Okay, so this is the pyruvate-alanine cycle that takes place in the human body. Okay. I'm trying to work it out. Probably because of large number of software it has hanged. So I will have to make a restart. Just give me 5 minutes. Just give me 5 minutes. I will be back on the mode within 5 minutes. Okay.